1997 Parris Island Marine Band Christmas Concert. I'm Master Sergeant Miller, your host for this evening's performance. Please welcome now to the podium the officer in charge of the band, Warrant Officer Michael Edmondson. Concert. Using many of the best-known Christmas carols, this arrangement has ushered in the Christmas spirit since 1950. Ladies and gentlemen, Leroy Anderson's A Christmas Festival.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. We would now like to introduce one of the newest additions to the band, the talented young trumpet player from Orlando, Florida, Lance Corporal Daniel Ireland. Please welcome Lance Corporal Ireland as he performs a rather unusual rendition of the toy trumpet. Selection in 1948 based upon the sounds he remembered as a boy growing up in New York. It has since become a Christmas classic. Please enjoy Leroy Anderson's A Sleigh Ride. Also, please welcome to the podium our enlisted band leader, Gunnery Sergeant Matthew Farquhar. And musicals, but perhaps his greatest contribution to music in this country was forming the American Society for Composers, Arrangers, and Publishers. The band's next selection was written for a 1903 Broadway show titled Babes in Toyland. Ladies and gentlemen, Victor Herbert's March of the Toys.
Thank you.
Shakespeare, and is best known today as What Child Is This? We hope you enjoy this Alfred Reed arrangement of Greensleeves.
Thank you.
Alexander Hamilton after his infamous duel with Aaron Burr. Moore was a scholar in Greek and translator of a Hebrew version of the Bible, but he would not be known today if not for a poem he wrote for his six children about a visit from St. Nicholas. Please welcome our very own Chief of Staff, Colonel Frank Bosom, as he does the narration for 'Twas the Night Before Christmas. I would also like all the children to gather at Uncle Frank's feet. Come on, children. Don't be afraid. Uncle Frank won't bite.
It was the night before Christmas when all through the house not a creature was stirring, not even a mouse. The stockings were hung by the chimney with care in hopes that St. Nicholas soon would be there. The children were nestled all snug in their beds. While visions of sugar plums danced in their heads. And my mom in her kerchief. And I, in my cap. Had just settled down for a long winter's nap. When out on the lawn there rose such a clatter, I sprang from my bed to see what was the matter. Away to the window, I flew like a flash, tore open the shutters, and threw up the sash. The moon on the breast of the new-fallen snow gave a luster of midday to the objects below. When what to my wandering eyes should appear but a miniature sleigh and 8 tiny reindeer. With a little old driver so lively and quick, I knew in a moment it must be Saint Nick. Right. More rapid than eagles, their courses they came, and he whistled and shouted and called them by name. Now Dasher, now Dancer, now Prancer and Vixen, on Comet, on Cupid, on Donner and Blitzen, to the top of the porch, to the top of the wall. Now dash away, dash away, dash away, dash away, dash away all. As dry leaves that before wild hurricanes fly, when they meet with an obstacle, mount to the sky. So up to the housetop, the coursers they flew, with a sleigh full of toys and St. Nicholas too. And then in a twinkle, I heard on the roof the prancing and pawing of each little hoof. As I drew in my head and was turning around, down the chimney, St. Nicholas came with a bound. He was dressed all in fur from his head to his foot. And his clothes were all tarnished with ashes and soot. A bundle of toys he had flung on his back, and he looked like a peddler just opening his sack. His eyes, how they twinkled, his dimples, how merry. His cheeks were like roses, his nose like a cherry. His droll little mouth was drawn up like a bow, and the beard on his chin was as white as the snow. The stump of a pipe he held tight in his teeth, and the smoke, it encircled his head like a wreath. He had a broad face with a little round belly that shook when he laughed like a bowl full of jelly. He was chubby and plump, a right jolly old elf, and I laughed when I saw him in spite of myself. A wink of his eye and a twist of his head soon gave me to know I had nothing to dread. He spoke not a word, but went straight to work and filled all the stockings, then turned with a jerk and laying his finger aside of his nose and giving a nod, up the chimney he rose. He sprang to his sleigh, to his team gave a whistle, and away they all flew like the down of a thistle. But I heard him exclaim ere he drove out of sight, Merry Christmas to all.
Of Corp Greg Markowski. For the young and the young at heart, we proudly present to you At Ease.
Parisian show band at ease. That tune was entitled Farandol, and the soloists on that were Corporal Andy Pazak on trumpet, on tenor saxophone, Corporal Joe Cortez, on trumpets, Corporal Joshua Stone, on trombone, Sergeant Nancy Reckles, on piano, Corporal Jason Petricelli, and on the set, Corporal Chris Brown. Also backing us up in the rhythm section, Sergeant Brendan Davis on guitar. And a member of the band who will be departing shortly to become a member of the Great North 1st District, 1st Marine Corps Recruiting District up in the cold, windy, wet, rainy, snowy northeast. That would be our own Sergeant Christian Flores on bass. Silent night, except we've given it a little rhythm and bluesy feel, and we're going to feature our wonderful male vocalist, Sergeant Matthew Eccles. Thank you.
Christmas ditty for you by Harry Connick. Hope you enjoy it. looked in my window Christmas Eve. My eyes were really droopy, but I really do believe it must have been old Santa, cause I saw his big red hat. And I know my mom and dad can't fly like that. Go, no. My dad had played since I was four. He stands outside my bedroom yelling ho ho ho, because he knows I don't believe in Santa Claus. No way.
Cause I don't believe in Santa.
I think my daddy sees me peeking through the door, but he pretends he's Santa anyway. Every year he tries to fool me. I'm a big boy now. I don't believe in Santa or his sleigh. So I went back to my bed and I curled up nice and tight. I stared out of my window and looked out into the night. When then all of a sudden, through my window I could see Santa Claus was flying by. It must have been old Santa Claus. Santa Claus, Santa Claus, happy ho-ho-ho to you. And then I heard old Rudolph telling me to come outside. He told me that old Santa wanted me to take a ride. I jumped out of my window and I climbed onto his sleigh. And then old Santa took me. So old Santa said, little boys like you should be in bed. So I hollered, oh, 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 and I put on Santa's hat. And then he led me home the reins wild. He pulled up to my window and I jumped back to my room. And I waved goodbye to Santa with a smile. When I woke up Christmas morning, well, it was clear and bright. My parents said my window had blown open in the night. I smiled as I told them that it must have been the cat. And they asked me where I got my big red hat. Yeah, yeah.
They asked me where I got my big red hat.
Come on, Santa Claus, Santa Claus. It must have been old Santa Claus. Santa Claus, Santa Claus, happy old. And I said, oh yeah, happy ho-ho to you.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Parris on the lead band, show band.
Presents a short skit along with its annual Christmas concert. The skit is based on a popular Christmas theme that has been altered to reflect some aspect of life in recruit training. We as Marines realize the vital role that the officers and drill instructors of the recruit training regiment play in keeping the customs and traditions of the Marine Corps. Without their work, we would not have a Marine Corps. This year's concert is no exception to that tradition. The Parris Island Marine Band proudly presents Gunny Scrooge. Old Gunny Marley was as dead as a doornail. This you must comprehend if you are to understand what I am about to tell you. Each year on Parris Island, the Christmas spirit fills the hearts and souls of both the young and old, Marine and recruit. why even the hardest drill instructor can occasionally be caught with the gleam of Christmas spirit in his eye. Well, all except one, Senior Drill Instructor Gunnery Sergeant Scrooge. Gunny Scrooge sits at his desk in his hard, salty camis. He is, as always, dreaming up new and innovative ways to play games with his recruits. He is hard, tough, mean, and recruits would even say sadistic in his training of the recruits in his charge. Not always the most politically correct individual, he is one of the few left in the Corps who refuses to release the ideal of bygone days, the old Corps. Before TQL, Total Quality Leadership, he believed in TQM, Tremendous Quantity Mass PT. He was, in his own mind, the epitome of what a leatherneck was, is, and ever shall be, from a young boot all the way to senior drill instructor. Why, he was harder than Sergeant Stryker from the sands of Iwo Jima. He was harder than Colonel Nathan Jessup from A Few Good Men. He was harder than death himself. And so it was that Gunny Scrooge was sitting at his desk, pondering the very existence of this day called Christmas. After all, he still couldn't figure out why everyone made such a big deal out of what should have been an ordinary training day. And now he, a senior drill instructor on his second tour at Parris Island, could not figure out why Sergeant Cratchit, his junior DI, would want a day off. If he would take a day off, he should want to take a loss of a day's wages.
I don't think so! That squad man is still filthy! I said I want it clean! Now do it again!
Excuse me, Gunny.
What?
Don't you think you're being a little hard on recruits out there? After all, they have been fielding the squad man for 17 hours now, and they are graduating tomorrow.
Not necessarily there, Sergeant Cratchit. I still have tonight. And Private Tim will not graduate.
But Gunny, all the recruits we have left are basically trained Marines, including Private Tim.
Yes? But are they Scrooge trained? One, did they all fire expert at the rifle range?
Why, yes. And Tim did too.
Okay. Two! Did they all qualify as expert swimmers?
Yeah. And Tim did too.
Okay. Three! Did they all score 300 on a PFT?
Gunny, all four of the recruits we have left scored 300 on a PFT. Including Private Tim, who happened to break his leg crossing the finish line. But he's the most motivated recruit we have.
All right, Cratchit! Four! Get every one of those recruits march across that parade deck tomorrow morning!
Well, you got me there, Gunny. Tim is on crutches, but...
Boom! Claymore! End of story! We will drop Private Tim, and we're gonna do it quickly, so as to reduce that surplus TQL population.
But for goodness sakes, Gunny, it's Christmas.
I don't care if it's the ring called birthday ball! I can do it all, and I still can. Now get out there and get my squad name Scrooge clean.
Hi, Gunny. Excuse me, guys. Late from the line photo campaign here to see you.
Yeah, sir.
Good evening, sir. Do I have the pleasure of addressing Mr. Marley or Mr. Scrooge?
That's Gunnery, Sergeant. Yeah, lady, besides, Marley's been dead for 7 years now.
Oh my goodness, may I ask how he died?
You sure can.
Marley got ran over by a reindeer. Home from duty Christmas Eve. You may say there's no such thing as reindeer. But as for me and Marley, we believe. He'd been drinking too much coffee. And he had no place to go.
But not everyone can become a Marine.
Is there no Army? No Navy? No Air Force?
People would rather die or worse yet deliver pizzas in one of those places.
Fine then! Let them deliver pizzas! And let them be quick about it! So as to decrease that surplus TQL population. Can I see you out, lady?
Why, yes, thank you.
Fine, I'm watching!
As Scrooge prepares to retire for the night, he can't help but think what a problem recruits are during recruit rap. All of this running back and forth to the exchange to get their parents' gifts and then sending them home. All of the phone calls home, as if they deserve to call home simply for Christmas. And the worst part of recruit rap is that it amplifies this pathetic existence of this humbug thing called Christmas. Ghosts or spirits, were there? Why would Marley tell him there was something wrong with the way he was training recruits? He and Marley had trained recruits to the best of their ability. They were a great team, weren't they? Well, sure, until that unfortunate reindeer accident. Scrooge must have imagined the whole thing. This whole incident must have just been a bad pork patty or some foul beverage powder. There would be no visits tonight, just another good night's sleep and then another training day. 'Twas the hour of one, and all through the squad bay, not a creature was stirring, except for the fire watch. Scrooge's deep snoring sleep would soon be aroused, for the drill instructor of Christmas past would soon come to bear and make Scrooge question his bravery in this horrific scare. With the ghost on the roof, with all of the clatter, Scrooge sprang from the rack to see what was the matter. And what to his wondering eyes should appear It sure wasn't Santa, and those sure ain't reindeer.
Dear dog, I feel it is necessary to let you know why I didn't show up for our date to the 200th birthday ball. As you know, we attended the ball for the 199th birthday of our beloved Corp. If you remember, while we were dancing, we discussed our future together. I mentioned the BAQ, BHA, comrades, and propay that we would be receiving, and you would just talk about base housing and your black belt and meritorious promotion. I mentioned our 2.5 kids, and you talked about senior drill instructor and series gunnery sergeant. I mentioned naming our family dog Muffin, and you talked about career drill instructor. And now, my dear dog, on the year of our 200th ball, I fear I must break away from his relationship. My marriage is your black belt. My 2.5 kids is your series gunny. And my dog Muffin is your career drill instructor. And never the twain shall meet. You must get on with your life, and I with mine. I will always remember you as that loving, caring Marine who lived only to please and to train. Take care. Given under my hand this 10th day of November, in the year of our Lord, 1975. Semper Fi, Susie Q.
Oh, madness!
Get on your feet. Research some fruits to cry. Quit your fault. Their eyeballs might sweat a little, but they don't cry. Susie Q was a good old gal, wasn't she, Cooker? I said quit crying. Sounds to me like she was crazy about you, too. Making all those plans about getting hitched, settling down and raising a family. You were a successful drill instructor at the peak of your career, envied by all of your peers. Everything was good to go until you screwed it up, Marine. Well, Pilgrim, I've got to go now. I've got some sand from Iwo Jima in my britches, and it's driving me crazy. You saddle up and think about what you've seen tonight.
Self alone again. What just happened? That MRE must have been very bad. Oh well, fiddle-dee-dee, tomorrow will be another training day. Inside the hatch, another creature appeared. He reached down deep for the courage he could muster up, and in came the ghost by the name of Colonel Jessup.
Not to mention I have to pack off Private Tim there.
Yes, I know. I said I'd be home right after Christmas, but... Yes, dear. But the gunny... Yes, sir, Sergeant. But I have it! Hi, Sergeant. Hi, man. Don't hang up! What?
Sir! Private Tim does not believe he will not become a Marine, sir. Sir, when this private first got here, he was 35 pounds overweight and could only do one pull-up. Thanks, MRP and PCP. This private is now slim and trim and dead hangs 20, sir. So this private also scored a 2.9 on the rifle range and has a first-class swim qual, sir. So this private was called a basic J Marine by the drill instructor earlier, sir.
Well, is he, sir?
You must be out of your mind raising your voice to me. Now, listen up. You're dealing with Gunner Sergeant Scrooge here. He doesn't have a place in his heart for a recruit that breaks his leg on a final PMT.
What will become of Private Tim, Ghost?
I see no eagle, globe, nor anchor in his future. Remember? And we're gonna do it quickly as to decrease that surplus TQL population. Is there no army, no navy, no air?
Is there anything I can do to change any of this?
Don't ask, and I won't tell.
I understand.
But I really want to know. Don't pursue this, Scrooge. My time here is done. I have a court date tonight. Some trash about a code red. I did my job, and I'll do it again. I eat breakfast 300 yards before